There's a husband and wife from Maryville who became a distributor June 14th, 2012. Today, they're diamonds. Could you do that? How many of you really think you, sitting there, have what it takes to move up, just curious now, move up to diamond in 3 or 4, maybe 5 years? How many of you think you can do that? Of course you can. Can. Big difference between can and will. But this couple did it. They saw a vision. They've told me their story. Some of the more private things they went through in order to get to where they are. Today they're diamonds. Their names, Ashley and Ryan Shepherd.
Wow. What a joy and honor and a true pleasure it is to be here with you, sharing our story from the stage. I want you to imagine something with me. Imagine you're with your family, on a blanket, having a picnic in a national park, and it's a gorgeous spring morning. That's exactly where Ashley and I were 3.5 years ago. You see, I took Ashley and the boys to the park to have one of those wonderful family memories that you and I both want, right? But it was really anything of the sort, because it was that day I realized my wife was uncomfortable in her own skin. She wouldn't get off that blanket and experience adventure through the eyes of her 2 young boys. It was 85 degrees. She had pants on, a sweater wrapped around her waist, because she was fearful of what people might see and what they might say when she got up and ran around and had a good time with us. And it was in that moment I realized that she's disgusted with herself on the inside and the outside.
And it's true, I had gotten myself up to 225 pounds, absolutely felt miserable. Food controlled me. And I'll tell you, my defining moment when I knew that it was selfish for me to not make a change in my health was when Ryan would be gone on a trip. He was gone a lot. I was a stay-at-home mom of our 2 boys, trying to be the mom and dad, but I parented from the couch because I was exhausted. And so he would call, "What are you and the boys doing today? You know, it seems like it's a pretty day there." And I would completely lie to him. I would tell him it was gonna rain or our kids are sick. I would give every excuse to not get off the couch and make memories with my kids. And so when I realized that my kids were missing out on life, then I needed to do something different, because that's just not good enough. Now, I'll never forget hearing the word AdvoCare from Lois Gregory. I didn't know her then. She said, "I'm going to coach you. I believe in you. I think you can do this." I thought, "Honey, you don't know that I'm addicted to chocolate, to brownies. My diet is macaroni and goldfish, sister. Good luck with that." So I was nervous. But you know what I did? My disgust level was so high. I felt so bad how I felt inside and out. Then I knew I needed to commit to those 24 days. Lost 19 pounds, and let me tell you, when you can get hope and confidence for the first time in so many years into a tired mommy, a fire just goes in my belly, and I knew it worked. I knew I could continue on. So it took me 2 years, and I lost 100 pounds, and I kept it off for over a year. But guys, it's selfish to not share these products. So right away, I didn't wait to lose 100 pounds to share these products. People felt the way I felt. I knew they had food addictions like me, and so I started sharing right away. Made an extra $500, $1,000, $2,000. I was like, wow, AdvoCare is taking a new form. It's taken a purpose in my life.
You heard that she had amazing product transformation, that she was making good supplemental money early on in her journey in AdvoCare. But this is the part of the story that I don't like, because she never mentioned my name. Where was I? I was skeptical. I was very skeptical. And I was stubborn, and I was selfish. You see, being a corporate pilot flying all over the world, when you're gone 5 to 6 days, only to come home, change your suitcase, hopefully kiss Ashley and the boys for a day or two, only to go back and do it again for another 4 or 5 days, it wears you out, and it wore me out, and it disgusted me. Every time I told my son, Wilson, my 3-year-old son, that he had to be the man of the house in my absence, that he had to watch over and protect his mommy, my wife. That's not the job or the duty of a 3-year-old. That's my job as a man, my duty as a husband and as a father. But I remember early one morning getting in the airplane and having a mindset shift, because I always told myself, AdvoCare will not be a long-term solution for me and my family. Ashley started this. I can't find my place. I don't have the personality to grow and thrive in AdvoCare. I don't know how to talk to people really well. I don't have the skills, the assets, the attributes that make successful people successful. But as soon as I stopped telling myself those excuses, I started making more money in AdvoCare. And that's exactly what we did 3.5 years ago. You heard that she was controlled by food. She wasn't the only person controlled. I was controlled by a schedule, by an airplane. Because whenever that airplane moved, I moved. Whenever that airplane moved, my family missed out on memories. And I was determined not to be the guy who always missed out on memories. And my defining moment is simple. It's every single day on the way home from work. I get in my truck, and I drive past this ball field, and I'd see fathers engaged in their children's lives. I could just imagine they promised to their kids that they would be at a certain moment. And I knew if I continued down the path I was going, I would never be able to promise my wife and my kids, I will be here, I will be there. But because we said yes to AdvoCare, because we pursue with passion and persistence, we get to be the yes parents. Our kids do not know the answer no.
And that's exactly what we did. When he came alongside of me, we started working AdvoCare together. We were able to supplement his pilot income. We paid off over $30,000 in debt. But guess what? Our 3-year journey was not perfect. In my health journey, there's been times I've gained weight back. There's been times I've had extra cheat meals. Anybody love to eat? We're from Tennessee. We eat gravy and biscuits, right? Okay, yes. And even in our business journey, guys, I had to recruit my own husband. It took 7 or 8 months. We had no-show mixers. We had people to this day that make fun of us. But guess what? Those people weren't there when my boys were crying for their daddy. They weren't there when I was showing their preschool programs on FaceTime. They weren't there. So we made the decision that we were not going to be perfect, but we were always going to progress forward, and we would never quit. Ever. We would never quit on our kids. We would never quit on our family. We would never quit on each other. And we would never quit on our amazing team. But I want to visually show you what never quitting looks like. So here we are 3 years ago. There we are on the white blanket where I trapped my family many a times. 3.5 years later, went to the same national park. We ditched the blanket, got on some bikes, and rode 11-mile loop in Cades Cove, because AdvoCare gave us the gift of health and the gift of time. I don't know where you're at today, but I can tell you this. You're not called to be invisible. You're not called to hide. You're not called to make excuses. We're called to give hope, and we're called to inspire other people. Just like Charlie Regis sat in his car on their way back from Disney and wrote AdvoCare down, right on your journal, where do I want to be in 3 years? Because I can tell you, 3 years ago, I didn't leave my house. And we're on this stage in 3 short years. So I'm here to tell you, if we can do it, you can do it. Thank you.
Bam, right there. Let's hear it one more time. The Shepherd's